Welcome into Jacksonville State. Ryan Hennessey alongside Kari Osep. Week one of fall football is officially here. Year number two for Rich Rodriguez.
I know. Football right around the corner, which we're excited about. And, of course, here in Jacksonville, all you Gamecocks fans are excited to see this team return to the field. But a lot of changes for this program. But also, Ryan, some familiar faces as well.
Yeah, Kari, a big name. Coming back for year number seven, quarterback Zion Webb at 24 years old. Granted a seventh year of eligibility by the NCAA back in June. Webb was the starter last year and excited to be back for one final season.
It's just a blessing, man, just to know that I get a chance to do what I can do again and just help my guys out and try to go get a ring.
And Webb overcoming so much adversity to return to the field, but one thing about this program is that they know how to move through transitions. This will, of course, be the second year under Rich Rod, but this will be the first year for the Gamecocks in Conference USA. But along with that, there's a lot of new additions that includes familiar faces for all of the local people around Central Alabama, including two guys looking to lead this defense while representing as homegrown athletes.
The truth is, the Alabama guys, you know, we're going to know a little bit about who we are. There's great high school football in this state. Not good, great high school football, great high school coaches.
They look to me and like, hey, he's doing it. Maybe I can do that one day. So I just try to lead by example.
Oh, it means everything, especially us moving up this year. It's been real great, especially everybody been talking back home and stuff. You know, they've been waiting, us being from going from SCS to FBS. I mean, it's a dream come true, you know what I'm saying? So everybody else back home looking up, and they expect a lot from us this year. We definitely are working towards it.
So, Kari, a lot of new things here at Jacksonville State. One of them, you got to see this, a cooling trailer. The first year they've had this, around 15 degrees when the players go inside, stuff that you haven't seen before on a football field.
Because, Ryan, when you make a hot transition into FBS, you need something cool, and this program is the only one to have something like this in humid, hot Alabama.
You know, it is a little warm, and it gets a little warm in the south here at this time of the year, but we want to get our guys' body temperatures down as best we can, and one good way to do that is a cool trailer right there. It's about 10 degrees. Put them in there for a couple minutes, and boom, they're refreshed right away. So the only thing we haven't done yet is put the coaches in there. So I think I get so mad, I probably need to put myself in there for a couple minutes as well.
And stepping inside of that, Ryan, there's nothing like it, but JSU is all about making transitions and changes, and something that this team's going to be looking at in the next year is a whole new upgraded stadium.
Yeah, speaking of upgrades, a new football facility that they're expecting to have done in 2024, something that's just a game changer overall for the Gamecocks. So year number two, Rich Rodriguez, should be exciting. Big changes ahead. We appreciate the time on Friday.
Yeah, it was pretty fun to get a behind-the-scenes scoop with this team, and we're excited that football is right around the corner for the Gamecocks. Here at Jacksonville State, I'm Kari Osep alongside Ryan Hennessey for WVTM 13.